Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 42nd video class of DIP, we will study run length coding in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. Starting with the name, what is the meaning of run? Run means how many times a particular symbol or a particular same symbol will be running or will be present, and length means the length of that particular run of the same symbol. So obviously, if the same pixel is being repeated again and again, we need not send the same symbol again and again, but rather we send it once and we send the length of that particular run. So in this way, we can achieve the compression. So we are learning different lossless compression techniques, in which we have already learned Huffman coding, arithmetic coding, LZW coding, and in this class we'll be learning run length coding. And these all techniques are lossless as compared to the lossy compression techniques like JPEG, MPEG, etc. So here, as these techniques are lossless, the data can be recovered completely without any loss. So let us start. Run length encoding is one of the simplest lossless data compression technique. It reduces the interpixel redundancy. It consists of replacing a sequence or run of identical symbols by a pair containing the symbol and the run length. So it is used as a primary compression technique in 1D, CCITT Group 3 FACS standard, bitmap images such as computer icons, and in conjunction with other techniques in the JPEG image compression standard. The run length coding works by counting adjacent pixels with the same gray level value called the run length, which is then encoded and stored. This run length coding works best for binary images or two valued images. It can also work with complex images that have been pre-processed by thresholding to reduce the number of gray levels to 2. The run length coding can be implemented in various ways, but the first step is to implement the required parameters. Horizontal run length coding, that is counting the rows along the rows, or vertical run length coding, that is counting along the columns, can be used. This technique is especially successful in compression bilevel images, since the occurrence of a long run of value is rare in ordinary grayscale images. A solution to this is to decompose the grayscale image into bit planes and compress every bit plane separately. So how to perform run length encoding? Scan the image horizontally or vertically, and while scanning, assign a group of pixels with the same intensity into a pair G, L, where G is the intensity and L is the length of the run. And this method can also be used for detecting edges and boundaries of an object. It is mostly used for images with a small number of gray levels and is not effective for highly textured images. Let us understand with examples. Say this is the string we want to compress, which is originally a 12-bit string. So G, L, where G is the symbol and L is the length. So the symbol is 5, and the length of this 5 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Similarly, so the encoded string is 5, 6, 4, 3, 3, 2 and 2, 1, and its length is, so the compression ratio that is achieved, assuming that both are 8-bit images, uncompressed image, that is 12 bits, upon compressed string, that is 8 bits. So the compression ratio is 1.5. The same example we will also implement in MATLAB. Now let us understand the example for a binary bit stream or binary image. So 1 is occurring 13 times, 0 is occurring 7 times, again 1 is occurring 9 times. So what we will do, we will write these numbers in binary. So 1 and binary of 13 is 1101. We will write 1101. Similarly, 0 and binary of 7. So encoded string, so this is 15 bits and the original string was, so the compression ratio, which is very good compression that is achieved. Now this run length encoding has one disadvantage, that sometimes when the number of repeating symbols are less, it gives negative compression, or rather you can say expansion. For example, consider this example. So it is a 8x8 image. So the run length codes using vertical or continuous top down scanning modes are like this. Then again going back. So 4 is occurring 9 times, then 5 is occurring 5 times, again 4 is occurring 3 times, and so on. So you can see that there are total 20 pairs. So 20 pairs, that means total 40 numbers. So for this vertical scanning, the compression ratio is, this is a 8x8 image, that means 64 upon 40. But rather than this vertical scanning, if we are using horizontal scanning in this direction, then it will give 4 is coming, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 7, 0, 1, so these are 34 pairs, which is equal to 68 numbers. So compression ratio for this horizontal scanning will be, so this is negative compression, or rather we can say that expansion. So this is the disadvantage of run length coding. We should not use it when the number of repeating symbols are very less, and we should also choose a scanning method, either vertical or horizontal scanning, so as to achieve positive compression. Okay. Let us implement the first example in MATLAB. So this program shows run length encoding and decoding of a string. We have choose the same string. Let us run and see the output. So this is our original input string, and this is the encoded string. 5 is occurring 6 times, 4 is occurring 3 times, 3 is occurring 2 times, and 2 is occurring 1 time. And we can see that we are achieving the same compression ratio of 1.5 as we achieved in the theory. And the output string after decompression is again the same string. And this program shows the run length encoding and decoding of an image. So we are choosing an image that is having only two values, 39 and 126. Let us run the program and see the output. So these are the pixel values. And this is our encoded string, 39 5 times, 126 2 times, and the same thing is repeated. So we can see that the original image and decoded image are same, and hence it is a lossless image compression technique. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.